Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today we continue with the series MLOps, and in today's video we will see how to do remote development with VS Code. I already uploaded a video long ago, I think, about how to connect to a session in Google Colab, but today we will see something a little bit more general in how to connect to different boxes, mostly remote infrastructure, covering from Dockers to Windows or System Linux, VMs on the cloud, and also to Google Colab. The connection that we use on that video, I think, was kind of 6 months ago, 7 months ago. With the new release of Google Colab, I think it's not working anymore. Today I will show you how to do it with other library, and that one is still working, so you will have the case that the previous trick I show you is not working. You can use this one case that you want to connect to Google Colab. Okay, to start, to do a remote connection, you need to install the Remote Explorer. This you can go to extensions if you don't have already installed it, and you can choose this one, Remote Explorer from Microsoft. And once you have installed it, you have an icon here on the left menu, and you have three sections: Dev Containers, Dockers, Windows or System Linux Target, if you have Windows or System Linux in your machine, and Remote Tunnels, which so machines that you can connect either using GitHub or Microsoft infrastructure, and connections via SSH, via SSH tunnel. So let's start with the containers. The containers, if you have Docker container installed in your machine, you can access or connect to one of the containers. In that case, I have, for example, I have this one running on my computer. It's just a Docker I'm working on, and then I'm running. You can connect your VS Code to this Docker. As you can see here, I have it, it's running a Streamlit application. You can connect to the using the desktop, you can connect to the shell, and once you have the Docker running, if you have as well the Docker plugin installed in your computer. Well, if you have the Docker plugin, you can manage the Dockers from your VS Code, but with this other one, with Remote Explorer, you can connect. So once it's running, this Dev containers is connected to your Docker infrastructure in local, and you can how to say connect to different Dev containers, case that you have access to them, and to the ones that you have here, you will see different folders with different Dockers running. In this case, only is connecting to my local one. Once you have it, you can simply attach. You will see the list of the running Dockers here under Dev containers, organized by folders, the local and the remote ones if you have access to. And if you just click here, you can either choose attaching the current window or attaching a new window. Attaching a new window, you will see that we are connecting to our Docker. You can see here the date a rack latest, and then you can see the software in your Docker, which essentially you can check here is the same machine, and well, you can now make changes, try something, install, and once you are happy with the stuff that you have done, you can leave, and you can save the changes in your Docker for the next time that you run. This is one of the options. Let's click it. the second one, let's cover first of all Windows or System Linux. If you had a VSL installed in your computer, like in my case, I have in my case a Debian setup, a Debian distro, and then you can just simply connect to that using as well the remote. This connection, and then on. You can see here, and then you can connect. It's exactly the same. Once you have it, you can check. It's keeping a history of the connections that you did to the different folders in your Windows or System Linux distro. And then you can either go to one of the history or just simply connect in the current window or in any window to the machine itself. And then once it's done, you just simply install the VS Server. It is not installed. If you already connected before, it will not install the VS Code server again. It's just reusing the one that you installed before, and you just can start working. It's going to the by default to the home of the user that you are using to connect to, and simply like that. So here we go to my home on Olonok, and then on it's opening, and now you are connected here, DS Debian, and you can connect also to the terminal. The terminal that you are opening is in your VS Windows or System Linux. LS, and you can check here, PWD is on Olonok, and -A is my machine in Windows or System Linux, which is on the background, is the same that there. And check here. Okay, so and the third option, let's close that one, is the remote tunnels. Tunnels here, you had two options, two providers, GitHub or Microsoft. GitHub offers SSH connections and Microsoft as well. We will not cover this in this video. I need to prepare. This is the options I use in one of the previous videos, but I need to rebuild that setup. And then once I have it, I will just dedicate one to cover this, because it's a little bit more complicated. Today we will see only the SSH. First of all, depending what you are going to use, if you are going to use simply SSH, you just simply press Control Shift P, and then you open the commands palette, and then first of all, to connect to any SSH to any host via SSH, you need to open your configuration file. By default, if you are working in Windows, you have it in your home directory, .ssh/config. You open it, and then here you see I have two connections. One is to a VN in Azure. And then you can here write the name. The name is this that you are showing here in the IP address. Then on the host name is the IP address. The host you can change for a label to recognize easily the host. Then on the identity file, in this case is a public key, and then on the user that you are gonna use. The second option is the one to connect to the Google Colab box. We'll first of all use that one. Once you have done the changes on your configuration file, you just simply save it. You just save this file, or you can go here to file, save the file, or save all, depending which changes you did. And then once you have your host you see your host here, you can do exactly the same. Either connect on the same window or connect in a new window. You connect to and connecting to a new window, and then you can see here how it's connecting via SSH, and it's doing exactly the same that we do with the other technologies. The VS Code server is not installed, it's installed, and then once it's installed, it's connecting your IDE via the SSH tunnel to the VS Code server running on the remote host. Here, you do the same. I had here connecting with the Detect AI user. You just go to repos, for example, and here, yeah, I'm connecting to this host, to the folder repos, and now, here I have my code. And here you are connecting to the terminal. You can see here I had an NVIDIA T4, it has not grown. Oops, NVIDIA SME. So exactly, and then on here if you need to do some tests in that and to test on new code or just stop or test your I used to when I having some issues, I used to have the especially in QA when in the servers that I had in QA, I used to have the repo with the software. I had also in this case everything is running in Dockers in this infrastructure. And then on what I used to do is just simply when I try to debug something, depending where is the issue, I try to create some temporal files here. I had the code, the same repository I use in local, I have it there in this server in a separate folder. And then what I used to do is configure the do some tests, create me a script to just test the component that is failing or the component where I adding new functionality and test it with or do some troubleshooting using the VS Code and the capabilities I had here, no? Especially the access to the terminal and the access in some cases like here to Docker. If you had like in my case here I had a Docker is running with another user, but well, you had access to you need to set up the plugin with some escalation access to the Docker infrastructure, but in any case, it's very useful when you need to do some debugging or to test some new functionalities, especially as I said, or either in test or development servers where you had infrastructure, similar infrastructure that the one that you will use in production. Here, as you can see, I had a T4. Obviously, it's far away better than the GPU I had in my local computer, and I'm able to test different models and different configurations. This is the way that we connect to AVN. This is AVN in Azure, but the same method works for AVN in Google Cloud or AWS. The only thing that you need to get is the keys, the public key to connect to your VN in the cloud, and with that you configure an entry on the config file, SSH config file, and that's it. You can connect later from your local environment to that VN. And the final one is the Cloudflare to connect to Google Colab. In this case, I'm gonna use I had an account in Google Colab with a T4 disconnection. You need first of all to download the Cloudflare client. So you have different flavors for Linux, Mac or Windows. I had the Windows version, the 64 bits Windows version is an executable, it's a binary file for Windows, and then I just download it into my downloads folder, but you can place it whenever you want. So far you had access to it. You can run the binary on that location. So once you download the binary according to the operating system that you are using, then you open a VS Code Colat notebook and install the Colat SSH, that's a library from this guy, a genius, which is using the connection the SSH server into the Colat box. The VS Code is not more than a Jupyter's enhanced, no, Jupyter server running in a runtime. It's a Linux box which had a lot of the pre-configured software. Depending on what runtime you use, these runtimes are prepared by Google, and they had access to you had access to different either no accelerated or access to different acceleration GPUs. So you can access with R or you can access with Python, and you can do some setup here. So depending on the version that you have, Colat Pro or Colat Conventional, you will have more or less resources. But the idea of this is also use the resources that you have in your Colat Pro. So once you have this installed, you launch the SSH Cloudflare client, and you simply write a password for the connection, and you have here is running as well this information. Here is writing down what you had to write in your configuration file, and then depending how you want to connect via SSH or via remote code, you just simply copy the host name, or this host name is not more than an address on the Cloudflare infrastructure, which is connecting the tunnels in between your local machine and Cloudflare and the box running Google Colab, so this one, and Cloudflare. So this now when you run this, the Colab box is connected to Cloudflare in this hostname, and then you write this entry in your config file exactly the same. The only thing that you need to change is where you had the binary. As you can see here, I have it in my downloads in the and it's a 64 bits X file. And once you have it, you just simply write Control Shift P. You copy here this address, Control Shift P. Here you Control Shift P. Connect to host. You paste the address there, and you can see here now it's setting up the server. Here is asking you for the password. My password. Previously, and is doing the same that in with the other technologies. Now you can see here in the down. Go here to the corner, left bottom corner. You can see that we are connected to the IP address. Now Again, it's asking me the password. Sometimes asks a couple of times. And now you can open here a terminal as well. And you can see here we are connected to the box. You can check. Let me open the box exactly. You can see here is the 1966. You have here the 1966. You have here as well NVIDIA SME. You have here your T4. So you are connected, as you can see here. And again, you can open your Google Colab, Roop, content, for example. Okay, I'm connecting to my content. Here, sometimes it's a little bit annoying asking several times. And that's it. So now it will open. You have it there, and sometimes it's a little bit slow, but it's good enough. No, you can check there. If you go to your sample data, it's exactly the same I have here. Okay, that's pretty much all. It's very useful, this plugin in VS Code, especially when you need to have access to a specific infrastructure, especially with acceleration, which usually you don't have in your local environment. I used to use it a lot, especially when I need to try a new model, a new component, where I'm using a model, or I'm doing a training or a fine tuning, and I want to use the pre-final code I'm preparing for this application. I used to use this either to connect to a VN on the cloud, or to connect to VS Code and do the test with a powerful GPU, which obviously you don't have access, or you cannot have it in your local computer. And that's pretty much all. I will upload now all the material to the repo as usual, and I will put a pointer to the location in the repository on the description of the video. And yeah, that's pretty much all. Thank you very much for watching the video to this point. I hope that you find this interesting and useful for your job, for your training, for whatever reason you're watching these videos. And if so, give me a like, subscribe to the channel, keep tuned, make comments, all this stuff to help me to grow in YouTube. Thank you very much, and see you soon.